Hello all, welcome back to our channel Complete Chemistry. Today we are going to see about your organic reactions, in which the first one is about substitution reactions. These substitution reactions are nothing but if in a reaction, if an atom or group in a molecule is replaced by one another group, then we call those as your substitution reactions. Let us take one example. In these substitution reactions, one sigma bond is formed and the other sigma bond is broken. If this is your chiral carbon, which with a leaving group, let us take leaving group as L, and then this will be reacting with the incoming group. Let us take the incoming group as your X. This is a nucleophilic group, and incoming group will be a nucleophile, and also a leaving group will also be a nucleophile. Then why this is getting replaced? This is getting replaced only because the leaving group is less electronegative than the incoming group. This will be more electronegative than the leaving group. So your group here in this reactant will leave. Leaving group will be leaving and incoming group will be attacking your carbon, chiral center, electrophilic carbon to form a product. What is a product that is formed? You will get a product like this, XC. Now this is X, that is incoming nucleophile, will be forming it with your carbon, right? This carbon is partially positively charged and this is partial negative charge that is present on your new incoming nucleophile. And what about the leaving group? Leaving group will be left out with a shared pair of electrons. The shared pair of electrons that are present in this bond because of the heterolytic cleavage. What happens is that we have seen in our last video that these two electrons will be leaving towards your leaving group because this is more electronegative negative group, which tends to attract shared pair of electrons that are present in the bond. Thereby, this leaving group will be leaving along with shared pair of electrons, right? Now we'll go to reactions. Now this is your SN1 reaction. SN1 is unimolecular. One here means unimolecular nucleophilic. N here means nucleophilic. S here means substitution reactions. Unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions. We are going to talk about, or we are going to learn today about your SN1 reactions. SN1 reactions are those in which your leaving group will be leaving and incoming group will be attacking your electrophilic carbon center, right, to form your products. And this will take place in two steps. SN1 reactions takes place in two different steps, right? We'll go and see what are the two different steps now. This is your example. Now in the step one, what happens here? Let us take the example of your carbon, which is electropositive, like partial positive charge on it, and leaving group, which is having partial negative charge on it, right? Now this leaving group, what will it do now? This will have a shared pair of electrons with it, and these shared pair of electrons will move towards itself, this will attract these shared pair of electrons towards itself, so that it will form a L with lone pair of shared pair of electrons and negative charge. Because this is gaining electrons, this will attain a negative charge, whereas this carbon is losing its electron, thereby it will get a positive charge here. This is a slow step. This is a slow, very slow step. So we call this as rate determining step. So the reactants will be forming your carbocation intermediate in your first step. Carbocation intermediate is formed in your first step with leaving group left out, right? What happens in the second step now? Coming to the second step, your incoming nucleophile, which is more electronegative than the leaving group, will be attacking your carbon electrocarbocation, which is trigonal planar in structure. This is trigonal planar in structure, or planar carbocation, trigonal planar in structure carbocation. So this nucleophile may attack either from top side or from the bottom side, so that this is a fast reaction giving rise to two products, either this or this. These two products are mirror images to each other. These two products will be mirror images to each other. What if this is formed? If this is attacking from the top end, what happens is the methyl group that is present on this bond will move back, and this will be moving away from this. The away carbon will be moving towards one side, and the towards us carbon will be moving down. Thereby, this is formed. And the above, like if nucleophile attacks from the other end, then this product is formed. So these two are mirror images to each other. This is a very fast step. So our rate of redetermining step is depending on step one. So the rate of the reaction or kinetics of the reaction can be written as rate is equal to K to the concentration of reactant along with your leaving group, because this is only important. This is the only one important in our step one, because nucleophile is not having any action in your redetermining step. So the rate of reaction will be depending on only concentration of your reactant, which is being with a leaving group here. Now let us take one example and then see this. So this is the example that I have taken. Now this is your planar carbocation with CH2, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3, and CH3, and this is your carbocation. Now attack of your water molecule, if it takes place from the top end, what happens from bottom end? What happens? Now this is your planar carbocation, and this is of, what is the name of this comes to be now? This is your 3-methyl and 3-hexane carbocation, right? This is carbocation, we'll just see it in your products. Now your water molecule will be attacking, if it is attacking from top end. Now attack of water molecule from your top end, what happens? So this product attack from top. So this is a product that is formed if it attacks from the top end, right? This methyl group, whatever is there, will go away from your site, from you. So thereby forming your away dashed structure here. And this CH2, CH2, CH3 will be as usual. There will be no change in its position. And this away group, that is CH2, CH3, will be coming on the plane. Thereby, you can write this structure in this way, right? Now this is called, what is the configuration of this? Now let us look to the configuration, R or S. Now this is given as number 1, and this group is given as number 2, because this is having a very long chain, right? And then this is given as number 3, and this is given as number 4. In our last video, we have seen about your RS configuration, where we came to know that the fourth group should be away from us. Now just turn or rotate it, like see the numbering of this. You should go from the fourth group, right? We have seen it in our video, right? Now this one will be going to 2 and then 3. So this is anti-clockwise or counterclockwise. So we say this as S configuration, S3-methyl, this is your 3-methyl, third group, this is your third carbon that is present, right? So 3-methyl and 3-hexanol, third carbon, OH group is present, so 3-hexanol. So this is your S configuration. Now let us take this one now. If it attacks from bottom side, what happens? Now this water molecule is going to attack your carbocation trigonal planar carbocation from bottom side. Thereby, the methyl group that is present here will be moving towards up, right? Thereby, it forms your group like this. And then this also will be coming onto your planar, onto the plane. Thereby, you can just mention this with a single simple line. So CH2CH3. This group, there will be no change. CH2CH2CH3 will be having no change. Now let us see the configuration of this group. Now the first numbering goes to OH as usual, because O is having atomic number of 8, right? So oxygen is having more atomic number, so this is given more preference. Then the second is given to this because of the longest chain, and third numbering is given to this CH2CH3, and fourth is given to this. But according to our RS configuration, the fourth group should be present either away from us or bottoms, right? Or to the bottom in your Fischer projection formula. This fourth group is not to the bottom side. Let us see what is the rotation of this. 1, 2 and 3. Now this is also S configuration. But because fourth group is not on the dashed structure or away from us, you should reverse this configuration and say it as R configuration. So this product is said to be R3-methyl-3-hexanol. So these two are your mirror images to each other. So the products that are formed from SN1 reactions are mirror images to each other. There are two different products formed in your SN1 reactions. This is how we explain your SN1 reactions, and these are mostly taken place in your alkyl halides. Your halides will be replaced with your OH group. Where in your alkyl halides, halides are replaced with your OH group, because halides are less electronegative than your oxygen, right? So halides will get replaced with your OH group in case of your SN1 reactions. Now let us see the factors that are responsible for your SN1 reactions. Let us see factors that are responsible for your SN1 reactions. The first factor is your nature of carbocation. Carbocation that is formed here should be most stable one. So the most stable carbocation is your tertiary carbocation, right? And then comes your secondary carbocation, and then comes your primary carbocation, and then comes your methyl group. So the carbocation that is formed here should be the most stable one. So tertiary butyl alkyl halides, tertiary butyl halides will undergo SN1 reactions because it forms tertiary carbocation as your intermediate. Thereby, this is the stable one. This we can say that tertiary carbocation formed is a stable one, right? So SN1 reactions proceeds through the stable tertiary carbocation. And the second important factor that is responsible here is your leaving group. I said leaving group should be less electronegative than the incoming group. So the cleavage of the C-Lg bond is the rate determining step. As the C and leaving group is a rate determining step, we can say that leaving group should be less electronegative than your incoming group, right? Thereby it forms your product in this way. So leaving group should be less electronegative than the incoming group. Then the third factor that is responsible here is your nature of nucleophile. Nature of nucleophile will not have any effect in these reactions because the redetermining step here is not involving your nucleophile, because nucleophile is attacking onto the electrophile carbon in the second step. So in the first step, that is your redetermining step, there is no action of your nucleophile. So your nucleophile has the least influence on the rate of reaction as it is not involved in the redetermining step, right? Then the fourth factor here is your solvent. Solvent here used is polar protic solvent. It is polar protic solvents are used in case of your SN1 reactions. What do you mean by polar? Polar means which has your bipolar groups like this. If it is H2O, this is partial negative charge and this is partial positive charge and this is partially positive charge, right? So there is formation of two poles, negative pole and partial positive pole. So these solvents are called as polar solvents. Protic solvents are those which evolve H plus ions into your reaction. Those solvents are called as your protic solvent. So the examples of your polar protic solvents are your H2O, ROH. All these are, etc. These are your examples of your polar protic solvents which can evolve, which can release H plus ions into your reaction mechanism and which has two poles in your solvent, right? Are called as your polar protic solvents. Then the next factor and the last factor here is your stereochemistry of your reaction. Coming to the stereochemistry of your reaction. In SN1 mechanism, the nucleophile attacks the polar carbocation with equal probability of attack on each phase, right? So your carbocation, which is polar in nature, is attacked from both the sides. It can attack from both the sides. Your nucleophile will be attacking from both these sides thereby. Hence, there will be a loss of stereochemistry of the reactive center as both products will be observed, which are mirror images to each other. So there will be loss of your reactant. Actually, the reactant will be in this form, right? Your leaving group, right? But there will be formation of your product either as like this, or you can also have this product, right? So the stereochemistry of the reactant is lost and mirror images are formed. Your nucleophile attack from top. If it attacks from top, this is formed, and if it attacks from bottom, this is formed, which are mirror images to each other. So this is about your stereochemistry of your SN1 reaction. So there are 5 factors that are responsible for your SN1 reactions. So these 5 factors you need to study about. This is about your SN1 reactions that is the very important topic in your intermediate engineering chemistry and also your degree. So this is what we want to see about today. Please watch my videos, like, share and subscribe to my videos. Complete chemistry. Thank you.